Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. So yesterday they announced the Swedish Aviation coming to the game, not with the tech tree. Just as a reminder, the Swedish tech tree for aircraft will not be released until update 1.95, but you will be able to fly one of the two, or both of the two, upcoming premium Swedish aircraft that will obviously be the pre-order vehicles for their air tech tree. We already looked at one yesterday, which is a rank 5 Swedish jet. Today is actually not a Swedish plane at all. It is a Finnish plane, which means it looks as though they are going to be combining the Swedish and Finnish tech trees together, which means there's a lot of really nice possibilities to see some Swedish and, of course, Finnish vehicles. This is, in my opinion, the more interesting of the two bundle packs, but, I mean, it usually always goes that way, the lower tier one. And this is, now, somebody in the last video said to go on to Google Translate, and I even got somebody that said the same thing on the Discord server, so that I don't fuck up the pronunciation. Screw you. You think it's that easy to go to just to Google Translate. That works for any other language, but this ain't any other language, this is Finnish. And there is no way you're going to get me to try to pronounce Finnish when I can hardly speak my own fucking language. So we're just going to be referring to it as either the VL, or the VMT, or of course, the Wooden 109, as it was nicknamed. Okay, so the VL is a Finnish late-war prototype fighter aircraft developed in an attempt to secure Finland's independent domestic fighter production in the face of the worsening war situation. Despite never making it out of the prototype stage, pilots will soon have the chance to take to the skies in the highly interesting VL in War Thunder's upcoming update 1.93. So briefly, it is a late-war Finnish prototype fighter designed to match the German Bf-109 in performance, but optimized for domestic production in Finland. And it is a beautiful-looking aircraft, but obviously it looks beautiful, probably because it resembles the 109. So it is the VMT-VL, which is a fighter. It is a premium aircraft for Sweden of the second rank. The pros are that it has good flight characteristics and bonus rewards for premium status, and the cons are that it has a lack of secondary weaponry. So I'm assuming that means no bombs, no rockets, no cannon pods, nothing like that. You get what you get in the nose, and that's what looks to be two machine guns and, of course, a 20mm cannon. Yep, it says a 20mm cannon there. Okay, so here are the pre-orders. A pre-order for the vehicle. You have the rank 2 Swedish aircraft there, available after 1.93. Comes with 1,000 Golden Eagles and 7 days of premium account, and you also get 2 pre-order bonuses, the Hurricane decal and the unique Tornado title. Okay, and as you can see right there, this is $19.99, and there's the Tornado decal you get. Now, I have to say, I am minorly disappointed with the title, the Tornado title, because I was under the impression that they were finally going to, like, bring in some really nice, you know, like a Finnish title that was in Finnish or whatever, but they didn't. Oh well, I guess, it's up to you to decide whether or not Tornado and, that works together. The weird thing that I'm a little, the thing I have a question on is, why is the title Tornado, and the decal is a hurricane, but that's clearly not a hurricane, that's a tornado? could somebody please explain that to me? Whatever, it is what it is, I guess. Anyways, the first two aircraft from the Swedish Air Forces will be available in upcoming update 1.93 Shark Attack. The closed beta testing of the Swedish Air Tech Tree will begin later in the following War Thunder Major update 1.95. Here we have some history on the unit. And then here we have some images of the aircraft. Very nice looking indeed. In War Thunder, the VL will not only be a highly interesting, unique, and no less powerful aircraft in itself, but it will also be among the first vehicles available in the game as a premium aircraft part of the new Swedish tree, coming to the game in the next major update. Additionally, being a premium machine available as part of a special pack in our online store, the VL will offer its prospective owners full access to the Swedish Aviation Tree for the duration of its initial closed beta testing period in update 1.95. So just like anything else, you gain access to the tech trees. When that releases. The VL can most easily be described as an attempt to create a machine nigh identical in performance to the BF-109G, ooh, my favorite variant of the BF-109, but adapted to the production capabilities and resources available to the limited Finnish wartime industry. As such, Finnish engineers fitted the VL with the DB-605 engine, the same one used on the German fighter, thus allowing the VL to reach a maximum top speed of 620 kilometers an hour at an altitude of 6,400 meters. Fun fact, the VL received its factory number PM1 based on the nickname Don't Even Make Me Try to Say It or Wooden Messerschmitt, given to it due to its similarity to the BF-109. Not only is the VL a close match to the BF-109G, but the Finnish design also offers a similar degree of maneuverability as its German cousin. As a result, veteran BF-109 pilots will have no problem switching over to the VL and vice versa. While newer pilots can look forward to a highly capable, fast, and agile aircraft fighter, ideally suited for energy fighting at medium altitudes. Yet never underestimate a BF-109's maneuverability, because it can, with high energy, I've found, except on later BF-109s. That's why I'm not too much a fan of the late BF-109s, as I am as, like, the mid-109s, like the early Fs and the Gs, like the G2 specifically. You get a lot of energy in that aircraft, and you just start outturning any American fighter you go up against. Okay, so here we got some screenshots. So here we can see the new Finnish pilot model that's coming, which is very nice. And we've got a nice shot. I mean, if you take away these wings and kind of the tail, and you just see the front end and you put it in black and white, you could easily mistake this for a 109. Although the armament of the VL isn't as stellar as its flight performance, it's certainly nothing to be ashamed of and will most definitely get the job done during dogfights. Namely, the aircraft is armed with a single 20mm MG-151 cannon and a pair of 12.7mm heavy machine guns, all of which are housed within the plane's nose section. And there you go, guys. So that is alongside the Swedish... let's see, where do they show the Swedish one here? Let's go to vehicles. So if you haven't seen the other one, oh, for fuck's sake. Of course, it's just going to be lost in all this because I'm not logged in. Fuck it. They show it down here. The other Swedish pre-order that you can get is the J29D right here. So this is the Rank 5 pack, which is more expensive, of course, but you get a jet out of it, and it is a Swedish unit in and of itself. So it's up to you to decide which one you want to go for, but that is it for this, and if you haven't been keeping an eye on the dev blog, here are some other things they've officially announced on the website. A bunch of new helicopter stuff, including the new Rank 6 Premium KA-50 Black Shark for the Russian helicopter tree, as well as the Mi-28N, a new Rank 7 helicopter for the Russian tree, and the Italians are getting a Premium Rank 6 A129 helicopter for aircraft, other than the two Swedish planes we already took a look at. The French are receiving the Rank 2693 AB2, and for naval forces, Rank 5 is coming to naval forces, and they said that it will be bringing bigger classes of ships later on, but as of right now, they are moving heavy cruisers to Rank 5, starting with the United States USS Pensacola, which is a new ship coming. And for ground forces, we have the new Rank 4 Premium Centurion Action 10 for Great Britain, as well as the Rank 6 Vickers Mark 7 for Great Britain. The Russians are getting the Rank 7 BMP-3, and for China, we are getting the Rank 6 ZTZ-96, which is a new main battle tank for their top-tier section of the tech tree. Awesome. But this isn't all of the stuff that's coming with Update 1.93. The dev server was open yesterday. They did the developer streams yesterday as well, and there was a lot of other stuff too. There are new premium light cruisers that are coming to the game. The British are getting a new heavy cruiser. The United States are getting things like the M1A2 Abrams. And the Chinese tree, the aviation tree, is getting three new aircraft premiums in the form of Japanese planes. So there's a lot of extra content, but as some people have been pointing out, yes, a lot of this update is premium content. Golden Eagle premiums and bundle premiums. However, something I didn't know until the dev server is that the premium light cruisers are not bundle packs, they are actually in-game Golden Eagle premiums. So in case anybody else was wondering the same thing as me, that's that. Anyways, guys, let me know what you think about the new upcoming Swedish tech tree and the Finnish plane in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.